The next theory is about protoplasm theory. After the middle of the 9th century, cell biologists started giving more importance there into the inner content of the cell. The protoplasm refers to the inner content of the cell. So, Hugo von Mohl in the year 1846 has first used the term protoplasm. What is protoplasm? It denotes to a tough, slimy, granular, semi-fluid like substance that has been present within the cells, especially in the plant cell. He has proposed the term protoplasm. Max Schultz is the main person who has been associated with the proposal of the protoplasm theory. He established a similarity there between the sarcode and the protoplasm. Sarcode refers to something that has been present there in the animal cells, and the protoplasm, as you already know, it is there in the plant. So he is the one who has found certain similarity between the protoplasm of an animal and plant cell. This led to formulation of a theory called as a protoplasm theory. Especially this theory was proposed by Hertwig. It states that cell is a accumulation of living substances or protoplasm that is definitely limited in space and possessing a nucleus and a cell membrane. So these are the important points there with reference to the protoplasm theory. What is a protoplasm? That is the one it has been proposed there, the protoplasm theory. Later, Huxley and Hertwig referred to protoplasm as a physical basis of life. So a cell's physical basis of life is depend upon the protoplasm of the cell. So protoplasm is a complex colloidal system having many inorganic and organic compounds. In such conditions, they have the ability to perform the life process of the whole organism. So that is again the outcome of the protoplasm theory. However, protoplasm theory has not gained much importance further. Why? This is due to the development of certain advanced techniques such as a cell fractionation, in which they can able to even fractionate the different macromolecular components of the cells. So by understanding about the importance of the cellular constituent, they thought that the inner cellular macromolecules may be playing a major role instead of protoplasm. So that is the reason why the protoplasm theory has not gained much importance in the further years. The next theory is the organismal theory. Early dissatisfaction over the concepts, especially the cell theory and protoplasm theory, has led to a modern theory or another theory which is called as an organismal theory. This theory emphasizes living mass as a whole is important for life rather than the cell. That is, cell is not an important thing, whereas the whole living mass of cells is an important thing. Original cells expands into a whole organism. This is again a proposal of the organismal theory. The point of original cell that expands into a whole organism could be better understandable when you look at into this diagram. So according to the organismal theory, the cell is expanding completely into the whole organism. So this thing has been very clearly depicted in this diagram. So as per this theory, the original cell expands into a whole organism. Thus, it is opposite to that of the cell theory. The cell theory states that one cell divides into many cells. However, here a single cell is getting expanded into the whole organism. Thus, as per this theory, the multicellular organism is a highly differentiated protoplasmic individual. Differentiation involves separation of the protoplasm into subordinate semi-independent entities, which are so-called cells. So it is entirely opposite to that of the cell theory. Even the embryological development of a small single protoplasmic individual includes only the growth and progressive internal differentiation of a small single protoplasmic individual. Even a embryological development has been correlated there with the organismal theory. Some discoveries that have helped in shaping this particular theory are stated below. They are mainly the findings of Richard. Richard has found some kind of a structured plan has been existing in all organisms, which is again a supporting point for the organismal theory. And the second one is the finding of Strasburger, who said that as per the points of the organismal theory, that is, one cell has been expanding into the whole organism, cell has been connected there in a living organism by different kinds of cytoplasmic bridges. That is, he has found that one cell has been connected with the other cell in a whole organism with the presence of cytoplasmic bridges. What are that cytoplasmic bridges? You just look at here the diagram of an animal cell. You can able to see the different kinds of cytoplasmic bridges. The cytoplasmic bridges are given with the different names such as tight junctions, adhesion junctions. So these are all names of the cytoplasmic bridges. Their explanations were also provided here. Such kind of a cytoplasmic bridges have been present there in the animal cell. Apart from that, some kind of a cytoplasmic bridges in the name of plasmodesmata was also present there in the plant cells. So these points again strengthen the view of organismal theory.